How to create an Amazon merch product listing using AI.
We're going to do an Amazon merch on demand listing with this design. If you haven't been following my series with doing research, check that out up here. The link's going to be up above in this video. You can kind of see the idea and the process of how I do my research. I ended up creating this design for this video for you guys to give you a better understanding. I want to teach you guys how I would do a listing. Okay, as I do the research and then the design is done, now we go ahead and find some really good keywords for the listing to get more eyeballs on this design. And if you're new to my YouTube channel, Amazon Merch on Demand, go over there and sign up. It's free. I like to say it can take anywhere between 3 months to a year to get signed up. Some people took about, 1 to 2 weeks. Me personally, it took me about close to 90 days, 3 months to get approved over here. And this is back in, I think it was like 2017, 2016. And basically what happens is you do the research, you upload a design on a product, let's say for example, on a t-shirt, Amazon will print and ship the product to the customer for you, and you do not deal with no customer service or no returns, which is really, really awesome. You don't have to worry about no inventory. So I went ahead and I uploaded the design over here to the back end of my Amazon Merch on Demand account. For some reason, I'm getting this little loading thing right now. I probably have to go back there and clear the cookies to get the design to populate over here. But what you're gonna do is pick whatever product that you want to list this design on. Okay, you can pick this one, or either whatever one you want. For this example, we're gonna go ahead and upload them to all the default products. And I won't mess with the pop socket iPhone case or anything like that. So let me come over here, select products. Let me just deselect those for this example of the video. You can obviously, select any products that you wanna get these designs up on and hit continue. And you can do any marketplace that you want. I will show you exactly how I'm gonna upload this design and create the whole listing. First things first, when it comes to any of this, one of the most important things is, I know people that don't even fill out the brand, the bullet point one, bullet point two, or description, they focus on the brand and then they focus on design title. That's the only two things they focus on. They don't focus on these other ones, right? And that's totally up to you. This all depends on you. This is how you wanna do it. But a good percentage, from my understanding over the years, a good percentage depends on the brand and the title, okay? It seems like when the customer searches on Amazon, it basically holds the most weight in the brand and the title. Okay, so it's important. That's why a lot of people just focus on that instead of the bullet point one and bullet point two and description. After it starts making sales, I think the bullet point one and bullet point two and the description, it holds a little bit more weight and it helps with the search in the algorithm on Amazon and Google or whatever search engine that your design is populating on or product is populating on. Let's focus on this. Let's do the research. And we're not gonna use Bing just yet. We're gonna use Amazon.com for the brand in the title. All right, so I'm over here on Amazon.com. And what I did was go ahead and type in blame it on the drink package, which is the same design that we have right here. Blame it on the drink package. This tool right here that I have right here that's populating, and it showed a lot of top focus keywords. Okay, it gives us a breakdown pretty much of the front page. Well, it says 2,804 products, right? So it gives us a pretty much a breakdown of this whole search term, right? My goal is to understand how the customer is going to search to find this design on a product, which would be, with Amazon merch. We're going to list it on a few different products as we've seen over here. So we're listing it on a few different products, from a zip hoodie to a standard t-shirt, v-neck, tank top, long sleeve, raglan, sweatshirt. I'm just going to go ahead and upload it to all those and just leave these ones out for this example. If you want to, by all means, go for it. I think it would look good on the tote bag. Now, with that being said, I would have to come in here and we're going to come over here. We're looking at all the products that we have, and we're going to have it on quite a few products. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 different products. And obviously it all depends on you. You can add it to throw pillow tote bags. They'll probably look good on these products too as well. Yeah, and so with that being said, we're gonna come back over, but we're looking over here at the top focus keywords, top long tail keywords, search suggestions. This is really cool because when it comes to anything like this, keep in mind, when a customer comes over to Amazon.com and they hit that search bar and they type something in, okay, this is the suggestions that it pops up. Okay, so you're gonna see blame it on the drink package shirt. So if a customer is typing in shirt, right, most likely they're looking for a t-shirt. And what does that mean? So if for example, I'm gonna hit that. If I hit that, it's gonna populate a new window, right? And it's basically blame it on the drink package shirt. Okay, Now, if we come down, you're going to see the different ideas down here. Okay, it's all on the standard t-shirt. These are all standard t-shirts except for this one. This one's a tank top. But you can see, you know, the different types of designs that are being populated. And one cool thing, if you look like at the BSRs, you're going to see that this one's a consistent selling one, right? And then, and keep in mind, this, we're doing almost like niche research at the same time as we're doing the listing, right? So you can see how powerful this is. You got the BSR of 229, 485. You've got some ones that are up there like in the millions. They come down a little bit more. 1 million, 3 million, 648. And you can see what they're using, like more of like beer here. That one was like a whiskey right here, whiskey glasses, right? You got a little flamingo. Probably has a drink in its hand with a little inner tube, right? And then we go down more. Just get an idea. This is interesting because if we go down even more, see t-shirt, tank top. So they're looking for it on tank tops, guys. So it's important that you check tank top. Women's, men's, tank top again. Okay, cup. They're looking for a cup. So if you can sell a cup on Amazon that says this, do it. Okay, it doesn't say you have to do Amazon merch. You can, you can do a seller fulfillment or FBA, whatever it is. Something like that, if you can think of a way it can be done. They're looking for it on magnets. Cruise, this is interesting because this could be a good keyword that we're going to use in our listing. Come down a little, blame it on my roots. Interesting. So now this is another idea, right? Because see, blame it all on my roots. People are actually searching for this right here. Okay. So it's important. This is really important that you put this, you kind of just take notes as you're doing this because you can find other ideas. That's basically that. But just cherry picking to understand, like, hey, what people are searching for. And we obviously know what people are searching for and what they want. Amazon's telling us too, and when this video of 2023, right, that if we put t-shirt or shirt, hoodie, they don't want us to do that, right? So basically what we're going to be doing is looking at the keywords without, you know, the actual product name in there. But now your suggested keywords, drink pouches, you can see bags. You can get, these are other ideas. So cruise, I think like with cruise ship, that can be, obviously that's what it is, right? Birthday, cruise ship, something like that. Those can be some really good keywords as I'm looking at this information. And this is suggested keywords from Google, okay? Which is cool because you can think about it. There can be some other stuff, another niche ideas in here. Cruises from San Diego 2023, and this is like getting from like local Google, right? And I think this is powerful too because you can see ideas and what people are doing and what they're doing in your area. And this can be shirt ideas too, right? So this is very powerful. And right off the back, let's go back over here and we're going to do the brand and the title. So the brand, we're going to just do, we're going to take that. I think I'm going to just do blame. Limit on the drink package. Okay. And then you can put like whatever. And then I'm going to grab that over here. And cruise was one of the topics, but I'm seeing 2023. And that's going to be like our placeholder. I'm going to come back over here and see like what else I can think will be good. I'm seeing drinking lovers, cruise, blame. Okay. Funny. Beach. Funny. Drinking. Okay. We're running out of space, but we got four characters, right? Ship. Can we fit that in there? Cruise, ship. No, I think ship would be a good one too, but I think we can get away with that right there. All right, so we're pretty much done with the brand, the title, and then we can do bullet point one, bullet point two in the description. What we're going to do here is basically the keywords that we can't include into the title or brand, we can go ahead and include it into bullet point one and bullet point two. So keep that in mind because you can even do this right here just to even do this. Cruise, ship, bam. You can even get away with that like that and do something because you can add up to, whatever the character amount here is. We still have three characters here and here. Okay. So we can get away with that right there. Then design title, we're going to go ahead and create bullet point one, bullet point two, and description. What I'm going to do is going to go ahead and see, blame it on the drink package cruise. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and copy this. Come over here to Bing AI. Now, Bing AI is a writing tool. It's going to help you. Okay. If you have Google Chrome, you can use it inside of Google Chrome. There's this little Chrome extension that I've been using because I don't want to be using it inside of their Chrome extension that they're wanting you to use. So Bing Unchained, this right here, it's a free Chrome extension that I've been using. But it opens up Bing inside here. Okay, so write me a product description for this design on design. Okay, send the message over here. Blame it on the, okay, it's giving us some examples of where it got this. We can also find a tank top with this design, which is really cool. Okay, so it's saying learn more. So if we click on this, right, it's gonna so bring us over here, right? You can see it's over here. We're over here, vacationshirts.com. And then if you come over here to amazon.com, it probably brings, yep, which is really cool. Bing is doing that. Let's do more precise. Write me 4 sentences. It says, for my product description. Okay. So I can see this one working. So what we're gonna do is come back over here. All right. Blame this in the, and then I'm gonna go ahead and come back over here again. And so so blame it on the, that works really good, right? And then enjoy the all-in exclusive drink package allows you to enjoy unlimited drinks through your cruise without worrying about the bill. This design, enjoy this with your, okay. So enjoy this with your all-in exclusive package allows you to enjoy unlimited drinks. So you see what we did right there. We come back over here to the AI, you know, it's given us some information. Okay, and then there's even more, like, can you add more details about the cruise, right? Change it, you can see right here, it's giving us like suggestions too. So change it up to more of a family friendly description. Okay, and let's see what happens. Remember, the goal is you're talking to this AI to spit out information to you so it can help you create a really good listing, right? Something to keep in mind when you're writing this product description in this niche, what are people doing? What kind of drinks are they drinking? Why are they getting this package? You know what I mean? Just kind of just think of stuff like that. And this right here, certain keywords that you're going to use can possibly help you rank you into the algorithm, and then people will get more traffic will come into your listing. Blame it on the drink package. Cruise is the perfect vacation for families who want to enjoy delicious drinks and refreshing beverages together. See, this can be a good one too. Our all-in exclusive drink package includes a wide variety of non-alcohol options so everyone in the family can enjoy their favorite drinks. From the fruity mocktails to refreshing smoothies and juices, our expansive drink menu has something for everyone. To gather the whole family, let us take care of the rest. After all, you can always blame it on the drink. See, that could be something too as well. It's all like a personal preference at the end of the day and how you want to word this. But one thing that I've done is, you know, just copy and paste it into here, right? And one thing you want to do is come in here and making sure that you're double checking for, you know, obviously trademarks and copyrights. But for the most part, just keep it very general and towards like what the design is or the niche is about. And you should be good, but always double check, right? You don't want to be doing nothing crazy. And that's what I pretty much do is try to keep things very simple, very general, and boom, to the point. And as I copy bullet point one, bullet point two in the description, bam. Look at that, guys. We have a listing that looks pretty good, okay? And pretty cool. And I can see, you know, something like this. And if you're creating a design, it's kind of give you an idea and inspiration on how to do that. It's a very, very powerful tool to use.
And do me a favor, make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up. And if you want to learn how to use ChatGPT to write a product listing, watch this video next.